Time now for the check on your pinpoint weather and traffic. Together we say good morning once again to Michelle Muscatel. Michelle, usually when we get, you know, like a snowstorm with a lot of snow accumulations, that's the type of storms that gets all the hype. But these could be more dangerous.
Yeah, this is a real difficult situation. Complicated forecast here as we undergo a transition between snow and sleet to freezing rain and then eventually rain. But the concern is that layer of ice that we get from the sleet and the freezing rain this morning, making for very treacherous conditions out there. And we're starting to see that reports of freezing rain in Newport right now. We do have rain. And at times some sleet along the Cape and the islands, and it's still mostly snow. Now, we had a live shot earlier this half hour out of Cranston. You could see large flakes of snow, and while it looks very heavy, that's actually a sign that the mid-levels of the atmosphere are starting to warm. And so when we get the big flakes like that, I expect it fairly soon after to start to change back to sleet, and that transition will continue as we push inland and the morning goes on. So about 31 now in Westerly. We're above freezing in Block Island, 34 already in New Bedford, and 36 out on Martha's Vineyard. So the transition to rain happening already in southeastern Massachusetts. Now, we got to scour out a lot of this cold air. We're still only at 19 in Smithfield. So as you travel farther inland, it takes longer for that warm up and the change over to plain rain to occur. But it should happen this morning by about, say, 10 or 11 o'clock for most of our area, the exception north and west of 295 as you get into those higher elevations. And it's up in this area we're concerned about maybe some significant icing, as much as perhaps coating to a quarter of an inch. That's going to really test our power lines, our tree limbs and branches. And as you add that heavy rain into the snowpack that we have all across our area, it's also going to put a lot of added pressure and weight on our rooftops. So a lot to be watching for as we head into the daytime today, but a mix changing to rain through about 11 o'clock most areas, but we hold on to icy conditions into the afternoon for northwest Rhode Island. Now, the intensity of the rain, the sleet, the freezing rain should start to taper off by mid-afternoon, with very light snow returning this evening and tonight. That's going to lead to some patches of black ice as temperatures tumble overnight. So even as this storm winds down, we could still see some slippery travel. But certainly this morning, it's very difficult going, slow, slippery travel. Additional 1 to 3 inches of snow and sleet inland areas. Some spots may see 4 inches in our northwest corner, coating to a quarter of an inch of ice in spots, street flooding as we change over to rain. And again, we'll be watching roofs, limbs, and power lines. This is a scene from our city cam. Just kind of tells the tale here of that layer of ice that's coating everything this morning. 23 is the temperature. We've got a north wind at about 9 miles per hour. So the morning commute, we've got it all. Kind of a kitchen sink type of storm with snow, sleet, freezing rain, and rain. Temperatures will be working their way from the 20s into the 30s. I expect highs today to climb up into the low to mid 30s. Drizzle changing back to light snow this evening, and temperatures will fall back to the freezing mark and then below that as we head into the nighttime hours, down to about 20 by dawn. So everything that's slushy, that's damp, the puddles, they go back over to ice tonight. Lighter rain as we head into the afternoon in Charlestown and in Westerly. Temperatures at 35 degrees. Coventry at 34. Northern suburbs, we're still going to be watching for icy spots. Burrville at only 31. Foster Center at 31. And Johnston's at about 33. And I've got us reaching into the mid-30s. Fall River and Westport, lighter rain and definitely not as cold. 7-day future cast for you. Well, this storm moves out tonight. Any light snow winds down, maybe coating to an inch in spots through this evening and tonight. Back to sunshine Thursday and Friday. And then the threat of some more snow and rain as we head into Saturday afternoon and night. And then possibly again middle of next week, later Tuesday into Tuesday night. Tony's back tonight live at 5 with another update. You can also get updates through the day on Twitter. Follow us at Pinpoint Weather Team.